We're going to develop the model of labor supply as a time allocation problem. I'm going to begin by going through this basic model to develop the ideas and the notation at the same time. So in this basic model, there are two goods, leisure and consumption. L denotes leisure, C denotes consumption, C is measured in dollars. L is measured in time units. Depending upon your application, that would be either hours, days, weeks, etc. The time endowment is denoted by T. So all the leisure time that's not used is T minus L. That time is the time spent working. Working does not create disutility itself, but only leisure time increases satisfaction. There is a market wage, which we're calling W, and at the moment there are no other sources of income. So let's develop the budget constraint. Here's how you think about this. The time spent working is T minus L. W times T minus L is the wages generated from work, and that is spent on consumption. So C equals W times T minus L. Or, and I'm now just going to bring WL over to the other side, W times L plus C equals W times T. In this interpretation, the opportunity cost of an hour of leisure is the wage, and the value of your time, if you monetize it, is the wage times that value of the time. You can put the same budget constraint in time units. So divide the whole equation by W and you get L plus C over W equals T. Or in other words, 1 over W is the time price of consumption. We can complicate the model in a more realistic way. We can allow for non-wage income, which I am denoting by I. We can also allow for an overtime wage that differs from the ordinary wage. So there is a base wage rate in this more complex model called BW, up to a certain number of hours worked, H. Hours worked above H are compensated at a higher rate and overtime rate, which is OW. In this more complicated case, the budget constraint becomes, let's get it up here, consumption equals unearned income plus the base wage times either the hours worked, if that's less than H, or up to H, plus the overtime wage, and this is the hours worked of overtime, which could be zero if you don't work so much, or it is measured by this number. Now, alternatively, again, we can bring over the leisure part to the left side of the budget constraint, and if you will, the opportunity cost for the first few units of leisure is the overtime wage. If you start taking enough leisure, then you no longer earn overtime, and the opportunity cost of additional leisure is the base wage. You add to that consumption, and you have on the right side the dollar value of your non-wage income plus the base wage times H plus the overtime wage times T minus H. This is the value of your time endowment.